How McDonald's makes money from real estate. That's the topic for today's episode. And without further ado, let's dive in. Hello, everyone, and welcome back to another episode. For those who are tuning in for the first time, this is your channel for real estate education. So today's episode is actually a one-off. In fact, it's a pilot episode that I'm running today. And what I want to do is basically do case studies, right? Do case studies on successful businesses that are related to real estate, analyze them with you guys, and just simply see if there's something that we can learn about those business models and incorporate them in our daily life in terms of real estate investing. So today is going to be all about McDonald's and how they're actually successful, right? So let's just start off from scratch. When you think about McDonald's or hear about McDonald's, the first thing that usually comes to mind is this or perhaps this, right? But what if I told you that McDonald's is more than just a fast food chain restaurant with addictive burger? McDonald's is in fact very savvy at real estate investing. So for those who actually watch my prior episode on the 7 books that I recommended in real estate, there was one book in particular, and that's the book from Robert Kiyosaki, and it's called Why the Rich Keeps Getting Richer, Why the Rich Gets Richer, right? And in that book, in fact, he talks about the 4 components of true diversification. And those are the components that everyone should have in their investing portfolio. That is 1, real estate, right? And then the 2nd one is a cash flowing business, right? And then the 3rd one is having something in the stock market. And then the 4th one is investing in commodities, right? So commodities are, let's say for example, gold, coffee, natural gas, anything that's utility related. So that's in terms of commodity, right? So the business model for McDonald's right here, right? McDonald's or Mickey D for some, right? So McDonald's has 1, real estate. They are a cash flowing business and they're also a publicly traded stock. So they have 3 out of the 4 important components that you will need for true diversification, right? So 3 out of 4, right? Just do it over here. So now you might be wondering, okay, but how does McDonald's exactly makes money, right? So 1, they make money off of their restaurants, right? And that's not a secret. But the way they make money off their restaurants is that 1 and 2 ways, right? So 1, they have restaurants that are self-operated, meaning restaurants that they run on their own, where they hire their own staff and they do all the marketing and anything that's needed for a business to be successful. And the 2nd way they run their restaurants is through franchises, right? So they, you know, sell the model of the restaurant to investors, entrepreneurs who actually want to come in and they want to run a restaurant themselves. So they go and they speak to McDonald's and they buy the right to operate a McDonald's restaurant. And in exchange, McDonald's charges the monthly rent for their restaurant. And on top of that, they charge a percentage of their sales that are generated every month, right? Then the 2nd way they actually make money off of it is by licensing, right, the McDonald's brand to other investors, right? So that's pretty much how they actually make money. And now I'm actually going to take a quick pause from the board and I'm going to go into my computer to actually show you the numbers and how they practically operate their business so that way you can learn to see 1, how to read 1 of those financial statements or the annual reports, and then 2, learn about things that they're doing to see if you can actually incorporate those into your investing portfolio. So I'll see you inside my computer.
Okay, so we're inside my computer and we are looking at McDonald's page, particularly the annual reports page. And if you don't have the link or you don't know how to get to this website, don't worry, I'm gonna give you a link in the description box down below. But in the meantime, just focus on this episode with me. So let's just go and scroll down. And as you can see here, McDonald's has annual reports that go from 2011 all the way running up to 2018. So for the purpose of this video right here, we're gonna look into their 2018 data. And now that we're in here, I'm gonna go ahead and zoom in. So I wanna make sure that you can actually see in your screen when I'm actually sharing with you. So as you can see here, this is the Form 10-K. And this is the form that they file with the Securities and Exchange Commission, SEC for short. And as you can scroll down here, you will see that this is the McDonald's Corporation, and it's been a company incorporated in Delaware, and that's their EIN number, yada yada. So we're gonna go ahead and scroll down. You can definitely take a look at this report at your own discretion, but for the purpose of this one episode, I wanna go ahead and jump straight into page 14 right here. So as you can see, McDonald's is including their annual numbers from 2018 all the way down to 2013, right? And just like I explained you in the board, right, McDonald's runs their restaurants in two ways. One, when they decide to self-operate their own restaurants, and that has brought them a revenue of $10 billion for 2018. And for those who are actually runs as franchise restaurant, that led them to earn a revenue of $11 billion. Total revenue for 2018, it's $21 billion, right? And as you can see here, their annual revenue has been slowly decreasing, but that's not the purpose as to why we're inside their financial statements and looking at their numbers. It is actually because I want to show you the trend and how they decided to run their business model, two, their real estate portfolio, and three, how they're actually adjusting to changes in the market, right? So like I said, everything you do in real estate investing and even in business is all relationship based, and the best way to mitigate any risk or you losing your real estate portfolio is to stay atop on the market, right? See how the market is transforming and decide whether this is the best time to go with a certain real estate strategy or whether to buy or whether to just simply get out of it, right? So if you look at this trend right here, all the way from 2013, you'll notice that one, yes, the revenue has been decreasing a little over time, but then at the same time, I want you to focus on the percentages, or at least in the breakdown of their revenue, right? So back in 2013, their revenue, 18.8 of it actually derived from self-operated restaurants, and then only 9.2 of that income was derived from franchise restaurants, right? And then as you go all the way up from 2013 to 2014, you start noticing a change, right? A change in the trend, and how this number at the bottom starts increasing, and then this number here at the top for self-operated restaurants, they start decreasing. So we went from 18.8 to 18.1, 16.4, and so on. And then in here, you went from 9.2 all the way up to 11.01, right? Now you might be wondering, okay, what does that have to do with me? And how do I draw the connection, right? So one, there's been a trend, right, in the market for people who has been wanting to eat healthier, which has led to McDonald's actually wanting to adapt to changes, make changes to their menu. And one of the reasons why they actually decided to stay in business with the food chain restaurant and still self-operating the businesses, it's mainly because they wanted to do market research, right? That's one way for them to be in the field, still engage with the consumers, see what is it that they're looking for, collect information and collect data. And at the same time, that will help them actually improve their models from the franchisees to, one, guarantee their customer success. In this case, with customers, I meant the entrepreneurs who decide to invest in a franchise restaurant with McDonald's. And that way they will know and continue to adapt to what the market is looking for, right? Now, if you're still wondering how do you draw the line, draw the connection between McDonald's and you or McDonald's and real estate investing, think of it this way, right? So the sales originated by company-run restaurants, think of it as flipping, right? So it is a very active way for you to earn your living. When McDonald's chooses to run their own restaurants, they have to bring personnel on board. They have to worry about the maintenance costs of their equipment. They have to pay for utilities. They have to pay for work permits, sanitation, you name it. It's very similar to someone who decides to go into real estate as a real estate flipper, because now you have to hire contractors, you have to make sure you apply for building permits, otherwise you'll get fined. You'll have to go to Home Depot or whatever distributor you have a relationship built with, so that way you can have access to building materials and everything that's, you know, engage in the whole house flipping business, right? But then if you look at the revenue from franchise restaurants, think of it as, you know, buying on hold. So the way McDonald's make money from their franchise restaurants is that every month, right, they charge a specific amount for rent, right? And at the same time, they charge a percentage of the sales that are originated by the franchise, right? So that's how they actually make their money. And if you come to think of it, you might probably be wondering, well, it's a $1 billion difference, but the numbers close enough. Yes and no. Yes, they are originating more of their revenue through their franchise business, but this is somewhat considered passive, let's say, so to speak, right? Here, even though they're making $10 billion, which is relatively close to $11 billion, they will have to worry about a lot of their operating expenses, right? So as you can see here, the model has been shifting, but at the same time, you can tell, or at least I want you to consider, for lack of better words, that even though McDonald's is making $18.8 billion here, there's a likelihood that there's less of income on this chunk of the equation, or at least on this top numbers, right? Because of the fact that they are running this in a very active way, and therefore they have to incorporate expenses. And as you see the breakdown here, after all operating income, after all taxes, from $21 billion in revenue that they managed to create, what they wind up with is a $5.9 billion in net income, right? And then let's just simply scroll down so you can learn a little bit more about what the business is about, right? And let's just analyze this together, right? So management discussion and analysis of financial condition and result of operation. And as you can see, here are the description of the business, right? But before we dive in any further, if you're enjoying what you're watching, make sure you hit the like button right now. And that way you can help support this channel and help this video rank. So that way you can help others who are seeking to increase their financial literacy thanks to videos like this. So now back into the screen, right? So the company operates and franchises McDonald's restaurants. Of the 37,855 restaurants in 120 countries at year end 2018, 3585 were franchised. Yes, are you surprised? As you can see here, only a few number of the restaurants that were franchised, in fact, actually brought more revenue than the restaurants that were actually run by the company itself, right? So we're talking about 2,770 company-operated restaurants bringing a revenue of $10 billion and 35,000 franchises bringing $11 billion and revenue. Now you might be wondering, okay, but look at this. They have to work, or they have to have more franchises in order to have 11 billion, but only 2,770 brought a total of 10 billion. And don't be so quick to judge. Let's just take a step back one more time. This amount, this number of restaurants is actually somewhat passive, right? They are only collecting the rent and they're only collecting percentages of sales from those franchisees. This number is creating 10 billion, but a lot of this is going to go towards an operating cost, right? In fact, McDonald's wind up keeping 16% of this number in income, and they wind up keeping 82% of the revenues thanks to their franchise model. So back to the bottom here, right? As you continue to read, you will notice that under McDonald's conventional franchise agreement, the company generally owns the land and building, which allows them to take advantage of depreciation, right? And secures long-term lease for the restaurant location, and the franchisees pays for the equipment. So they don't have to worry about maintaining equipment, signs, seating, and decor, because the franchisee is the one that's going to have to pay for it. They don't have to deal with that. So again, it's more of a passive business model, so to speak, right? And it's very closely related to the model of buy and hold, right? So the company believes that ownership of real estate combined with the co-investment by franchisees enables us to believe restaurant performance level are amongst the highest in the country. Franchisees are also responsible for reinvesting capital in their business over time. In addition to accelerate implementation of certain initiatives, the company frequently co-invests with franchisees to fund improvements. So think about it as, you know, capital improvements that you will make to your properties, just sort of like when you renovate and you increase the equity of your property. So this is an excellent business model, right? These investments developed by collaboration by franchisees are designed to cater to consumer preferences, improve local business performance, and increase the value of our brand through the development of modernized, more attractive, and higher revenue generating restaurants. Under McDonald's, the developmental licensing or affiliate arrangement, licensees provide capital for the entire business, including the real estate interest, and the company generally has no capital invested. So this is what we're talking. So this business model right here is when they actually, you know, license the privilege to the brand so that foreign affiliates can actually use the McDonald's brand. So primarily China and Japan are the ones that use those licenses. And then as you continue to scroll down, right, you will learn that McDonald's is primarily a franchisor. In fact, the goal is to move away from actively managing their restaurants and actually shift that ratio to 95-5, meaning 95% of the restaurants are going to be mainly franchise, and then only 5% of those restaurants are going to be company managed and company operated. And I'm thinking, once again, it's mainly because they want to continue to do the market research, get that engagement with the customers, and see where the shift is actually heading to. When customers come into the store, what are they asking for? Are they asking for a quarter pounder, or are they asking for a healthier version, let's say a salad, right? So now back to this report right here. McDonald's is primarily a franchisor and believes franchising is paramount to the delivering great tasting food, locally relevant customers, which is something that I kind of got ahead of myself and started sharing with you guys. Now here, directly operating McDonald's restaurants contribute significantly to our ability to access a credible franchisor. One of the strengths of the franchising model is that the expertise from operating company-owned restaurants allow McDonald's to improve the operations and success of all restaurants, while innovations from franchisees can be tested when viable, efficiently implemented across all relevant restaurants, right? So this is definitely a great model, right? It's something that is excellent to implement in your real estate portfolio. Like I said, when you're investing in real estate, you shouldn't look at the business itself as just passive income flowing in your way. Real estate is a relationship-based business. And at the same time, you have to look at your portfolio like it is a business. So that way the IRS and the banks can actually treat you as a business person in and of itself. So, and then the next thing I wanted to show you is all the way down onto page 20. So let's scroll down all the way down there. And you can see that here, right? So here's the breakdown of all the expenses. Like I said, sales derived by company operated restaurant, we talked about it, it's 10 billion. Now the franchise are 11 billion. And then you can start seeing how much of this money is costing McDonald's. So out of the 10 billion, you can see that 8.2 of that revenue is actually going towards operating expenses for this, right? For this number right here. And for those restaurants that are operated as franchise, of the 11 billion, only 1.9 goes towards expenses, right? Then you have the other administrative expenses, 2.2 billion, and other operating income expense, for a total of $12 billion, right? And then this is what they pay in terms of interest, right? And then taxes right here. As you can see, the number and taxes is actually relatively low compared to the expense number that you see here. Why? Because McDonald's is in the business for real estate. They're not entirely in the business of selling burgers, flipping burgers, even though their burgers are delicious and addictive. As you can see, McDonald's takes advantage of all the deductions that they can get, whether it's derived from their company operating expenses, it could be derived from depreciation, and all sorts of advantages that the US tax code can actually give you. So that's it. That's all I have to show you inside of my computer in this report, and I'll see you guys back outside.
Okay, so hopefully you really enjoy the analysis that was done inside my computer. Now, let's just do a quick recap into what we talked about, right? So McDonald's, they have their self-operated restaurant, they have their franchisees, and we learned that out of their self-operated restaurants, they keep approximately 16% of their revenue. And for restaurants that are actually run as franchisees, they actually keep 82% of the revenue that they make. So there's a big difference here, but not all is bad. You might probably be thinking, well, then they should do everything just in terms of franchisees, right? Just like I mentioned before. But the reason why they want to continue to take advantage of their self-operating model is because, one, it allows them to do market research. That way they know exactly what is it that the consumers are looking for. And that way they ensure not just success for themselves, but also for their franchisees. And at the same time, it would allow them to take advantage of the United States tax code, right? Because when you're running an active business and as well as a passive business, you get the opportunity to deduct your expenses, right? So in this case, if you're running something that is active, you get to deduct your personnel expenses, right? You get to deduct the operating costs from running all of those restaurants. But then even on the franchise model, right, you get to take advantage of other items such as the depreciation on the property, right? Real estate related, which you can translate to either 27.5 years if you have something that's residential. But in the case of McDonald's, it will be 39 years. Or you can also have the choice to depreciate the use of the equipment that it's used in that restaurant to, you know, make the delicious burgers and coffees and anything that you want to stop by McDonald's for. So that's it. Hopefully you find this episode valuable. Let me know if you want more episodes like this in terms of case studies, and I'll do my research to find more, something that is more relevant for your everyday learning. And while I still have you here, don't forget to check out this episode right here, which I specially picked out for you, just that you can complement everything you learn in this video today. So that's it. I will see you soon, and do not forget to subscribe. Take care. Bye-bye.